let's get back to basics. With the essential network commands, every IT technician must have in their toolkit. We'll explore commands common to Windows and Linux, and I'll demonstrate their PowerShell equivalents. From diagnosing network issues to setting and checking configurations, these commands ensure you manage your network like a pro. For this demonstration, using Windows 11 24H2, we have a Windows terminal with three panes. The top left is old school Windows command prompt. The bottom pane is Windows PowerShell. To ensure we get complete help information, type update-help in an administrative PowerShell session. Ignore the errors about the commandlets where help cannot be updated. We are using both native PowerShell 5.1, which is part of the operating system's Windows Management Framework, and the new PowerShell 7.x, which is based on the latest cross-platform .NET, which should not be confused with the .NET framework. The top right is a WSL Ubuntu Linux distribution. However, for some commands, I'll demonstrate from an SSH session into a domain-joined Ubuntu Linux distribution. For Ubuntu Linux, we need to install a few packages to obtain some legacy network commands. A quick word about command prompt and PowerShell. Most command prompt commands can be run in a PowerShell session or terminal. However, PowerShell commandlets cannot be run in a command prompt. Although I have a dedicated command prompt open for this demonstration, defaulting to a PowerShell session is often more effective. For command prompt commands, type command/?? To see all options and syntax usage. For PowerShell commandlets, precede the command with help to see all options and syntax usage. For most Linux commands, typically follow the command with --help or view the command's man page. IPConfig, as a utility, operates at OSI Layer 7, Application. It is the Windows command line utility that manages and displays detailed network configuration information, including IP addresses, subnet masks, and default gateways for network adapters. Using the /all option displays additional information, including adapter MAC addresses and DNS servers. The /display DNS option displays the DNS cache. The /flush DNS option purges the local DNS cache and forces new lookups to use the DNS server. The Get-NetIPConfiguration commandlet is the PowerShell equivalent to IPConfig. Adding the -detail option provides even more significant information, including network profile and MTU size. Combined with the -verbose option to see the other commandlets referenced to coalesce the information. To view the DNS cache, use get-dns-client-cache. To clear, use clear-dns-client-cache. We can also use the get-net-ip-address commandlet to obtain the IP address, but the information it provides is lacking. In Linux, IP address is the loose equivalent to Windows IPConfig. Linux, by default, does not maintain a DNS cache in memory to clear. Type IP to view help and usage information. The Linux legacy command to IP is ifconfig. Ping operates at OSI Layer 3, Network. It is the command line tool that sends ICMP echo request packets to test network connectivity between a source and destination, measuring the response time and counting any lost packets, helping identify connectivity or latency issues. By specifying the packet length with the -L option, ping can help verify if jumbo frames are enabled. However, depending on the configuration of the destination, ping results can be misleading. The test-connection commandlet is the PowerShell equivalent to ping. Use the -buffer-size option to specify packet length. And the -source option allows you to specify a host other than your computer as the source. Ping works pretty much the same in Linux as it does in Windows. Use the -s option to specify packet size. PATHPING operates at OSI Layer 3 network and is the Windows command line utility that combines the functions of ping and TRACERT to diagnose network connectivity and performance a longer route to a destination. However, since it also calculates the degree of packet loss at each hop, it can take longer to complete. The test-connection commandlet with the -traceroute option is the PowerShell equivalent to PATHPING. However, this particular command and option combination is only available with the new PowerShell 7. The PowerShell 5.1 version of the test-connection commandlet lacks this capability. For Linux, use the mtr command, which is pretty awesome. In WSL, you might get a pretty little GUI window. In an SSH session, the results are displayed within the terminal. NSLOOKUP operates at OSI Layer 7 application. It is used to query DNS servers to help diagnose and troubleshoot DNS-related issues by retrieving DNS record information for a given hostname, domain name, or IP address. By using the -query option, we can specify the type of records queried. We can tell NSLOOKUP to use a specific DNS server by appending the IP address to the end of the query. The PowerShell equivalent to NSLOOKUP is the Resolve-DnsName commandlet. Like NSLOOKUP, we specify a particular DNS server and record type by using the -server and -type options, respectively. Although NSLOOKUP is not deprecated, the preferred method in Linux is to use the dig command. We can specify a DNS server by using the @IPAddress parameter and limiting the record type by appending it to the entire command. NETSTAT operates at OSI Layer 7, application, but the connections it displays are at OSI Layer 4, transport. It is used to display active connections, listening ports, and other network statistics, and allows monitoring of incoming and outgoing connections and identification of open ports. One of the most common option combinations are -ANO. To see only listening TCP connections, pipe the output to find string using the -I option to ignore case sensitivity. You can now see open listening TCP ports and the associated PIDs. The Get-NetTCPConnection commandlet is the PowerShell equivalent. Pipe the command to the sort-object commandlet to obtain an output similar to that produced by NETSTAT. As the name implies, the commandlet only applies to TCP connections. Although NETSTAT is present in Linux, the modern replacement is the SS command. Since the SS command lists all sockets, use the -TCP option to limit the output and combine it with the -listening option. TRACERT operates at OSI Layer 3, network. It traces a packet's network path to a destination, domain, or IP address, and helps diagnose and pinpoint network issues. Since TRACERT uses ICMP, there may be hops that time out, as denoted by the asterisks. There are two alternatives in PowerShell. The test-netconnection commandlet with the traceroute option, which is available in all versions of PowerShell. However, it does not list the running output as TRACERT does, but the command dumps the final results. The test connection commandlet with the tracefile option is only available in a new PowerShell, as mentioned earlier. This commandlet, however, does list a running output and provides results similar to TRACERT. In Linux, traceroute is the tried and true command to trace a package route to its destination. ARP operates at OSI Layer 2, Data Link, and is the command line tool responsible for displaying and managing the ARP cache, which maps IP to MAC addresses on a local subnet. ARP-A is used to view the current table. A poisoned ARP cache can be cleared with ARP-D asterisk if necessary. The ARP table will be rebuilt. The PowerShell equivalent to ARP is the Get-NetNeighbor commandlet. The dash address family option limits the output to only IPv4 IP addresses. However, to remove entries, use the remove-netneighbor commandlet. The ARP-A command works in Linux the same as it does in Windows, but the new preferred method is to use the IP-neighbor command. Route operates at OSI Layer 3, Network. It is the command line tool to view and manipulate the local IP routing table. A common usage is the route print command. Append the -4 option to view only IPv4 routes. The get-netroute commandlet is the PowerShell equivalent to the route print command. Use the -address family option to limit the view only to IPv4 routes. Notice that the destination is listed in CEDAR notation. To add or remove routes, use the new-netroute and remove-netroute commandlets, respectively. In Linux, the legacy route command displays the routing table. The IP route command is the new method, and it displays the destination using CEDAR notation. GETMAC operates at OSI Layer 2, Data Link. The command returns the MAC address of any installed network adapters. Personally, I feel this command is outdated and useless since IPConfig/all provides MAC addresses. The Get-NetAdapter PowerShell commandlet provides a cleaner, detailed output. In Linux, both ifconfig and ipaddress show the interface MAC address. NetSH, Network Shell, deserves special recognition as a powerful command line shell, allowing users to configure and display a wide range of network settings interactively or via scripts. The help menu displays the list of commands and subcontexts that can be run interactively. If you type netsh, the command drops the user into the network shell as denoted by the netsh prompt. I'll go into the interface IPv4 subcontext. Type show to see the context commands. To see IP addresses in this context, type show addresses. Likewise, we can call netsh and run a full command, context, and subcontext from the terminal. Here are common netsh command and context that align with some of the tools we have covered. ipconfig/all, netsh interface ipv4 show config, netstat show TCP connections, ARP, show neighbors, GETMAC, show IP net to media. And here are a couple honorable mentions to see some stats. Show IP stats, show TCP stats. It is worth mentioning, however, that Microsoft recommends using PowerShell to manage Windows networking technologies. Although not a networking command per se, SYSTEMINFO is just as important and useful since it provides detailed system information. However, one thing missing is the system's serial number. The get-computerinfo commandlet, however, does return the serial number provided it is listed in the BIOS or UEFI. You'll also get other information such as domain role. For Linux, use the lshw command. However, you have to run it using sudo or as root. I hope you enjoyed this video, learned something new, and found it useful. If you have any feedback, corrections, or suggestions, please let me know in the comments below. Please like, subscribe, and pass it on to others. And I thank you for watching.